Figure skating is a little bit unique in that it used to be primarily figures and tracing things on the ice, and now a lot of the emphasis is on jumping, and repetition is needed in order to get the jumps right. Jumps are the number one thing that the skaters and the coaches want information about. Most overuse injuries are likely related to the landing specifically. And we haven't in the past really had a good way of measuring those forces or even tracking the injuries well. The device that we created at BYU is a lot like a wearable fitness monitor like your Fitbit or other monitors that you've seen. The difference is that we've made a three-step algorithm that looks for the confounding movements in figure skating.
There's an accelerometer that measures the accelerations every time you jump and land, and then a gyroscope that measures how fast you spin. Whether you're on the ice or in the air, we can pick up the rotation speed.
The three devices work together, so the accelerometer measures acceleration, the gyroscope measures angular velocity or how fast it's spinning, and the magnetometer measures the direction. And so we use these three devices to provide jump count, jump height, and how fast they spin during a jump. So we've taken the measurements and then we've used them in an algorithm in a way to mathematically calculate the number of jumps that a skater does.
So most people don't even really keep track of how many jumps they do, but that might be important from an injury standpoint.
I know that like when I'm on the ice and I get really mad because I can't land the jump, I just keep doing it and doing it, and I've gotten several injuries from that. And so I think it's important to know like, oh, whoa, I've done like 100 double axels, maybe I should stop for today so I don't hurt myself.
They're doing a lot of jumps every day, trying to get their technique down. But the main motivation for us is to help the skaters train smarter and more efficiently. The skaters, coaches, and US Figure Skating has been very interested in this device. Finding a way to get this technology into a small market sport like figure skating will open up some doors to change the sport for the better.